Hello and welcome on Watches TV, and today we will talk about one of my favorite Vacheron Constantin timepiece, the American 1921. And as its name implies, well, this watch is celebrating its 100th year anniversary, but let's say that the date is more of a symbol, as the first iteration was developed in 1919, and only 36 models have been manufactured in the early 20s before it was actually relaunched as part of the historic collection of the brand back in 2008. So let's now talk with Laurent Pervez from Vacheron, who will come back on the specificities of this watch and the new models presented today.
At the end of the 19th century, we see the first wristwatch. We go from pocket to wristwatch. Vacheron Constantin's first wristwatch is from 1889. And with the wristwatch, we see a big liberation of design because we're going to go away from only round design shape typical from the pocket watch to go to other types. And then Vacheron Constantin is going to really experiment all kinds of shapes, cushion, square, horizontal placement of the dial. And he's gonna, among these designs, he's gonna be one in 1919 and then in 1921, which has an asymmetrical positioning of the numerals and this very specific, they called it a camber square, now we say cushion shape, that is gonna become iconic later on with the American 21. At the time, Christian Selmoni, our heritage director, is at the head of the creative department, and him and his lead designer, Vincent Kaufman, who's still with us today actually, we're looking at the archive and we're looking at this fantastic shape from the 20s. As I was saying, it started in 1917 up to like the mid of the 20s. And they came to some archive documents already showing like how the watch was conceived with that circle in a cushion shape, with the very fixed positioning of the crown at the angle, the Arabic numerals. They fell in love with the model. And they decided to relaunch it. First, there was a sort of design vision of making something different. And then there's many stories. The first one is that it's a driver watch. And that, you know, at the time, the steering wheels are quite large. And so with this asymmetric position of the dial, you can actually watch the time while you're driving, having the numerals rightly placed. Another legend is the one of the preacher's watch. And here again, the legend says that when he was giving his sermon on the pulpit, he could watch discreetly the time thanks to the asymmetrical dial of the American 21. There was no way to predict the success, so it was launched in 2008. Immediately was very well received, became sort of an icon for the Maison. We decided 8 years later to launch a second version, a smaller size, 36.5, because there was a very high demand. We had then like several limited edition references across the ages that were launched as declination as the model was very successful. Until today, where we celebrate the anniversary of this watch and we realize that in fact, in the course of 13 years, but also in the course of 100 years, it really became an icon for the Maison. So we didn't come with something, I would say, crazy. We came with something that really pays tribute to the original American 21 and its reedition of 2008, hence the introduction of two new models in white gold, 40 millimeter and 36.5 millimeter, with a new silver tone sandblasted dial with that very specific grain. And we have something, I would say, we didn't change much, but it changed a lot. Because the monochromatic effect of this watch makes it look extremely slim, extremely refined. You have a very high contrast of the Arabic numerals. And it's really a new interpretation of the American 21. Also with new straps, we kept our collaboration with the luxury leather watch maker, in Italy, Serapian, and we have beautiful calfskin straps that have been exclusively designed for these new models. So it's a state-of-the-art manual winding base caliber for Vacheron Constantin. As I said, we use it across several collections. It's only 2.08 millimeter thick, so makes it very easy to adapt to several case and configuration. In the case of the American 21, we have 8.06 millimeter thick case. It's a 4 hertz frequency caliber, which has a 65-hour power reserve, which makes it very comfortable to use for manual winding movement. And of course, it's a Poinçon de Genève validated movement with a state-of-the-art finishing and decorations. For the white gold version, it's true that when you're used to the pink gold and yellow gold version, you might find it thinner. It's the same architecture, it's the same movement, the 4,400 manual winding movement. But indeed, because we're on a monochromatic construction, meaning the dial and the case are on the same shades, although they have a very different treatment, you can have this impression that the watch is indeed a bit slimmer, very sleek, very elegant. As a matter of fact, it's not, but it's the, let's say, the visual illusion it gives, which gives it a very also contemporary look that we are really looking for. Because through the 100th anniversary, what we also want to show is that a design can be 100 years old and still be very relevant to today's usage. And as we discussed it many times, we think that today we are back a bit to understatement, smaller size, classical discretion and sophistication, which is typical of Vacheron Constantin. But it's not all. We also thought about collectors. American 21 has been very early on a favorite from our most loyal clients. And so we're coming for the first time in the historic collection with a collection excellence platine declination of the American 21, which means like all platinum concept, the dial, the hands, the case, up to the stitching, which is a mix of silk and platinum. And of course, as for every collection excellence platine model, we're in a limited and numbered edition. And because it is the anniversary of 100 years, it will be 100 pieces for this one.
Thanks for watching. Really like the design of the American 1921, and Vacheron Constantin launched a few other models which I hope we'll be able to come back to, because there are some really interesting and complicated ones. Anyhow, all the very best, see you real soon, and viva watchmaking!